Congratulations. You've just been honored by your peers, your fellow casting directors, and just how are you feeling? What does it mean to you to be honored by your peers?
It's an extraordinary thing. It's very humbling to be nominated at all, and the group that I was nominated with is a bunch of casting directors that whose careers I've admired, you know, over the years, and to be in that group, let alone to come home with the award, is an amazing thing. So it's great.
It's wonderful. Every project, I think, probably brings with it its own challenges or opportunities or memories. Is there something about this particular project, especially, I think, because of the unique nature of the story, but is there something about this project that sticks with you that is unique, or something about this process that you'll really carry with you going forward?
Well, the fact that at the center of the movie there is a mother and a child, and the child is absolutely one of the leads in the film, is a challenge when a child that young has to carry the film. And so the concern over finding a kid with the ability to carry a film, but also to be natural and to inhabit the world that he inhabited, was quite a concern. But we did it, and Lenny directed him beautifully. So it worked.
The relationship between those two characters is so beautiful. Can you speak a little bit about the challenge of not only finding an actor to fulfill a part, but to find two actors to build such a relationship together, and whether or not your process involved individual, or how did it work casting them together?
You go for great actors, you go for good actors, and Brie worked hard to get the part of Ma, and she was clearly the right girl for Lenny's story. And then really, you know, as a director, Lenny prepared his two actors beautifully to work together. So really, it's always a case of just getting the right actors for the part and then letting them do the work with the director.
There's been a recurring theme tonight. I think I've heard it a bunch, that part of what we do, we love storytelling. And ultimately, we are collaborators, freelance storytellers, all working together. And I think that's true for writers, directors, actors, casting directors. So I'm curious, for you, what about casting appeals to you as a storyteller? Why, what drew you to casting? Why casting as opposed to perhaps any of the other ways to contribute to the stories we create?
Because it involves human beings and human spirits. And when you read a script, if you have a different director, you could have different versions of the same story, you know. And so it's that balance between the director's vision, understanding their interpretation of a story, and creating that, help to create that with them, finding them. And it's that understanding that so much of a story is the human interpretation of it and presentation of it. If that makes any sense.
I think extremely well said.
It's been a long night.
Extremely well said.
Probably I won't. Been really inarticulate.
No, absolutely quite the opposite. Trust me. I won't keep you. Maybe one last question then, just because I'm curious. Now that, you know, award-winning casting director, if you have advice for people coming up through the casting world, young associates and assistants who are looking to grow their career, become CSA casting directors, what one piece of advice would you give young casting directors?
You have to appreciate and love acting and actors, and you have to work hard, and you have to be kind to actors. The rest is down to you.
Perfect. You said you weren't good at this. You said you weren't good. And you know you never apologize for a read, right? You know that, right? You never apologize for a read, ever, right?
Okay.
So well done. Thank you very much. Thank you for your time. I really appreciate it. And congratulations again on just a phenomenal project. Beautiful film.
Thank you.